Hey, Tim Berglund here with a few words on Kafka brokers. Now, when I was talking about partitioning, I did kind of mention that Kafka is a distributed system, but let me just be explicit about that for a moment. Now, we've talked about events, topics, and partitions, but I have not formally introduced you to the actual computers that are doing this work. So from a physical infrastructure standpoint, Kafka is composed of a network of machines called brokers. In a contemporary deployment, these may well not be separate physical servers, of course. These could be cloud instances or containers running on pods, running on virtualized servers, running on actual processors in a physical data center somewhere. I mean, we all know how that goes in the cloud. But however they're deployed, whether they're that or they're physical pieces of sheet metal whose blinky lights you can see and whose fans you can hear and feel, these are independent machines, each running the Kafka broker process. So each broker hosts some set of Kafka partitions and handles incoming requests to write new events to those partitions or read events from them. Brokers also handle replication of partitions between each other. Other than that, brokers don't do a lot. They are intentionally kept very simple. And that's a key design priority. You want to keep them simple so that they'll scale easily, they'll be easy to understand, modify, and extend as Kafka evolves into the future.